Hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Jade Monkey Gaming, bringing you today a review of Solar 2. Now, this game is an indie game that is actually out and already available on Steam, and the general concept of the game is that you are a planet in space, or a body of mass in space, flying around an infinite universe. So, you've got two options in this game. As you can see, kind of orbiting my asteroid at the moment, there's various pointers and markers pointing to missions, which are set to you by the god of the universe. And this god is humorous, and he enjoys having a bit of a joke, and these missions are actually pretty entertaining to play. But the other thing that you can do on this game, which is more interesting, rather than just staying as a boring old asteroid, is if you, in the asteroid stage, if you crash into other asteroids, as you can see, I've now grown into a small planet. And in the small planet stage, you get asteroids to orbit you, and you can actually keep growing from a small planet all the way up to a planet with life on it, as you can see is my next stage. And once you go from life planet, you then actually get to a point where your mass is so high and the gravity and the general force is going that you become a star and you can get planets orbiting you. Now in the life planet stage, so if I skip forwards to a life planet, in the life planet stage, as you can see, I've got myself a shield bonus, and these fighters are coming out from me, and you carry on growing exactly the same way as you would when you're a small planet. So you just keep on growing, and you've got orbital defenses, and there's different missions as from where you're an asteroid, and there is so much freedom in this game. I mean, you can do missions if you want, and there are various rewards for when you do the missions, but you have to do all of them, and there is actually a bit of a special ending, but I won't spoil that for you. Or you can just go around and try and make yourself as big as possible, or make the biggest, most complex systems as you can. So if I should go forwards a little bit further, so you carry on growing from a life planet, eventually you erupt into a small star, and as a small star you can have planets orbiting you, and then the way to grow as a star is, well, you swallow those planets, unfortunately. There we go. So you swallow your planets, and when you swallow your planets, you get bigger and bigger, and you can just get hold of some more stars. Now, the way you get planets into orbit, or the asteroids in the same way, is you kind of have to fly a little bit closer to them and get them into your orbital kind of range. But once they're in the range, you can either make the planets grow themselves to make life planets, or you can swallow them up and increase your own mass. Now, if you keep growing the planet around you, eventually you may end up with a situation where you actually have one of the planets explode into another star around you. As you can see here with this system that I'm currently flying around, it actually has two stars and four planets orbiting it. And you can keep growing planets around you until you get to a point where you have about six stars orbiting you, and there's actually a Steam achievement for doing that. Now, if you keep growing, eventually, as to go with the general laws of physics, you go from a small star to a medium star, which can have more planets orbiting it, to a large star, which can have even more planets. But then if you keep growing, eventually your mass becomes so big that your star actually supernovas, and you collapse down into a neutron star, which has incredibly high mass, but not very big in itself, and it cannot sustain many planets around it. So you end up with this lovely pinkish neutron star with four planets orbiting it, and you can carry on growing until you get to a clustered system of stars. But if you keep growing yourself, eventually you become the general ultimate destructive force in the universe, the black hole. And when you're in this stage, your only danger is being swallowed by a bigger black hole. And your only objective is to just swallow the universe. And you keep going, and when you swallow the universe, well, something happens, but I won't tell you what. I'll leave that to you. Now, I've talked about the actual game in itself, and some of the good points about it. Well, there's so much freedom. It's a game that because there's no, like, single, you have to do this, blah, 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 because there's, like, the option of growing yourself or just doing the missions, there's a lot of freedom. So if you're not in the mood of doing missions because some god's ordering you to, you can go ahead and just, I don't know, go off and just grow yourself and see how big you can get. But if you want to do the missions, then you can. Now, the universe is infinite. I could keep holding right and I would never hit any sort of boundaries, which is really amazing. And the general graphics of the background, there's a big one over there, the general graphics of the universe in the background are actually pretty, very pretty. I mean, you've got all the nebulae behind you and stuff like that. So it's quite interesting to just watch. Unfortunately, it does get a bit repetitive, the background, that is, to the sense that you kind of see the same nebulae over and over and again. But that's hardly a point worth really moaning about. The humour in the game is very subtle and very good. Like, the god has a general sense of humour, and some of the missions that he sets are quite... the story behind them is just like, well, you know, this isn't true, but it's still quite funny. And the missions themselves that the god set, you'd think there wouldn't be a lot of, you know... You'd think, oh, there's not going to be much choice in kind of like a mission situation when you're just a planet. You're going to just have like, go here, get this many things. But there are actually some pretty creative missions that they've done for us. So, the bad points about this game. Now, you might expect, I guess it's not really that much of a bad point, but something to note is the controls feel a bit sluggish at times. Like, the black hole, if I try and speed up now, he takes a while to speed up. And now I'm trying to slow down, and he takes a bit of time to slow down. But when I guess you've got a mass of 235k, it's kind of expected that you're going to be a little bit sluggish. The other really annoying thing about this is that mass counter goes up. Now, if you hit a planet when you're in the planet stage, you'll lose a huge amount of mass, and then you have to rebuild that mass. And if you get to a point that you lose a lot of mass quickly, you actually die and your mass counter goes to zero, and you have to start all again. And it's the same with a black hole. There was one time that I was getting towards the big crunch, as it was, and the universe started getting swallowed in, but all of a sudden, a slightly bigger black hole than me just swallowed me up, and my mass counter went straight down to zero, and I had to start again. And that was quite infuriating. It's very much like you've worked hard, and then all of a sudden you've had to go back to square one. So that's probably the most annoying thing about this game, is just being able to lose so easily. But this game itself, it's available on Steam now, so if you just search Solar 2, it'll come straight up. It's a very good game, I do enjoy it. It's a game that you can pick up and put down and pick up again later, and it's not incredibly long. There is missions for each stage of star, planet, and asteroid, and life planet as well. But there's no missions for the black hole. So it's not the most longest game out there, but it's definitely... it's got some playability for it. And the price itself is $6.99 on Steam. And I think that's quite reasonable for this game. The graphics in itself is good, the gameplay is really good, it's got some humour, it's very playable, it's a very good indie title. It's not incredibly expensive, but it's not cheap either. So if you're looking for a game, you've got a spare tenner lying around that you want to spend, and you haven't got any idea, then go ahead and buy Solar 2. It's a good game, I enjoyed it. Anyway, thanks for joining me. This was Jade Monkey Gaming giving you a review of Solar 2. Please subscribe to my channel, like this video, or comment. And any suggestions of any games to review, or upgrades for my channel, or any suggestions on something that I could do better, please do drop me a note and say, and I will take that into account. Also, there's my Twitter account there, if you feel free to go ahead and follow me. A lot of the stuff is my random ramblings, but you're more than welcome to follow me and listen in as I just... crap on Twitter. So, thanks a lot for joining. This was Jade Monkey Gaming. Goodbye.